Welcome back, guys. Today I thought I'd do just a short video letting you know where I stand with Puppy Linux. As you know, I've been playing with it over the last few days, and it's been a terrific learning experience. I really like it. I like solving problems, and so I've had to go through a lot of that, but the community at the Puppy Linux Forum is outstanding, and they've been able to help quite a bit. Now, let me show you what I've done so far. I do have my printer working. If you look into, let's see, setup, Cups Printer Wizard, and if I look at printers, you can see I have my brother printer configured. It's working fine. I was able to download the drivers from the brother website. Everything is a little bit different than Ubuntu and Debian and Arch. So the install procedure was different. And if you guys enjoy this video and you'd like to learn a little bit more about Puppy, drop me a note in the comments, and I'll do some tutorials on how to install printers and your NVIDIA drivers and things like that. So I do have my printer working, and I do have Ethernet. I was able to get my Broadcom Wi-Fi working on my main computer. Let's see here. Under setup, as you can see, I have NVIDIA 340.76. And that's, I can get up to 352 on my main computer. Using Puppy Linux 6.0.5. That's another thing. This is 6.0.2, but it's been upgraded. If I click on Quick Pet, you can see I'm up to Service Pack level 6.0.5. The reason is the newest 6.0.5, if you download that from the Puppy website, it won't have Quick Pet. And a lot of things are not quite ready for it yet. They're not compiled yet. So what I did was I downloaded 6.0.2. I installed that. That gives me QuickPet and a lot of other things. And then I did the service pack upgrades. I went to 6.0.3 and then from there to 6.0.5. And then you can just click on Updates. It goes through the update procedure and updates your system. And then with QuickPet, which is not available in 6.05, but it is available if you start off with 6.02, as I mentioned, you'll keep your QuickPet. Then it becomes an easy way to install a lot of different applications. And as you can see in QuickPet, most of the common ones are here. Now I'm going to show you how easy it is to, and by the way, you can install XFCE and LXDE, you can install Compiz and Emerald. So Puppy is full featured. It's different. I'm not going to say it's harder, but it's different. And so it's just a matter of learning the new procedures. So I'm going to close that out. Now, I also have BattleNet installed. I can play my Hearthstone. I have Steam installed and fully functioning. And I will show you exactly how easy it is to install. Now, have been saving all of my pet files, which are programs or packages. I've been saving them all in a folder on my flash drive. Makes it a lot easier if you're doing multiple installs. So as you can see, I've downloaded the package files for a lot of different packages, and so I've installed most of them except OpenShot. I saved that one for you just so you can see how quick. If you have the pet file, which is just a matter of downloading it, and you click on it, it will ask you if you want to install. Yes. It will install it. It will let you know that it's been installed and what category it's been put under. If you click OK and go to Multimedia, you'll see OpenShot is listed. And it's just a matter of click and open. So let's see. I've got my temperature in the showing in the icon in the tray. I've got my firewall enabled. I've got Ethernet access. I've got BattleNet running. I've got Steam installed. My printer is configured. I've got Wi-Fi. I've got GUVC view and simple screen recorder for doing this video. And let's see, there was one other thing I wanted to show you. Let's go through the package manager. Package manager is very nice. All you need to do is you have several different repositories on the left. I leave it on any type of file. If you click on the search box and you type in what you're looking for, more than likely it will bring it up for you. Not sure if they have WPS Office. No, they do not. And there are other repos that are available that I have not enabled. And so that might be something you guys, if you decide to try Puppy Linux, you may want to do a little more research there. I've pretty much left the repos alone. But as you can see, the programs are broken down by category. If you go into multimedia, there's all kinds of programs available. And so you're really not at a loss for anything. Whatever you want to do, it's just like any other Linux flavor. Whatever you want to do, you're able to do. Now, one of the things I wanted to go over with you is I had heard, and I mentioned this in my MX-15 video, I think. I heard that the newest version of Chrome, you were able to play Hulu streaming video. In the past, I've had to use Firefox, and I've had to reconfigure some things to get Hulu to stream. So last night, one of the last things I did on this computer last night was to do a little research and find out how I could load up the newest version of Chrome on my Puppy Linux, to see if I could get Hulu going out of the box. Now, it turns out that I was able to do that. Now let's take a look at the Google Chrome. If I check the version, it's 48.0.2564. I believe that is the latest version. When I go into Hulu, it works. As you can see, no problem with that. Now, if I go into Netflix, no problem with Netflix. And if I go into Amazon Prime, no problem with Amazon Prime. I haven't had any multimedia issues at all. I'm going to close those out so I don't get over the audio bleeding into the video. I haven't had any issues at all with any of the multimedia. I even tried, let's see, Steam. So I opened up Steam and I loaded up my account, and one of the things that I, and it's connecting now, one of the things, I have a video that's in my library and I wanted to see if I was able to stream that, and Steam videos stream nicely. Steam games play nicely. Shouldn't have any issues there. Now, most of this was pretty easy to configure, but I did get a lot of help over at the Puppy Linux discussion forum, and I'm signed in there now. If I look at all my posts, you can see I marked most of them solved. I was able to get answers to all of my questions, particularly a gentleman named Semi, S-E-M-M-E. He was super helpful. He went above and beyond giving me the information that I needed in order to solve some of the problems that I had with my initial install. And as you can see, I've got pretty much everything working that I have in any other Linux distribution. And so that's, and it only took me a few days of digging in, learning, and I really enjoyed it because Puppy is very, very nice. Now, you don't need to, you do not need to keep this icon configuration. In the setup or desktop, you'll find the, let's see, Desktop Drive Icons Manager. That is for changing your icons. So Desktop Icons. Okay, so this configures what you want to see on your desktop as far as icons go. Now, there is another one. There's Font Manager, Window Manager. Joe's Window Manager is what I have running here, but you can change that. And let's see, there's a Theme Chooser. So there are a few themes installed. Everything here is basically out of the box. There's only a couple things that I actually changed. I put the Faience icons because I prefer those, but Desktop Icon Switcher, that's where I have the Faience. But there's, out of the box, you've got about a half dozen varieties that you can try. There is a program available where you can change this pattern configuration to a more traditional, but I like it just the way it is. I think it's different, sets it apart from some of the other distributions. So as you can see, everything is running fine. I'm really happy with the system as it stands now. And so, as I said, if you guys are going to try Puppy Linux and you'd like me to do a few tutorial videos on the NVIDIA and the printer, Wi-Fi, Steam, Play on Linux, any particular topic, I will attempt to help you. I am by no means a puppy Linux expert. I had to rely on the expertise of the folks over at the Puppy Linux Forum, and they were super helpful, as I mentioned. So that is it for this review, guys. I hope you enjoyed this little exercise. Please rate, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you soon. Take care.